everyone, welcome to this update video. I hope you're doing really amazing. I sure am this morning because it is my 20th birthday. So my birthday coincides with the official start of the Pacific hurricane season. So today's also the start of the Pacific hurricane season, and we may see development happen as we head into the end of this week and into next week. So I just thought it was so cool when I first, you know, got interested in doing meteorology and just knowing about natural phenomena, and then finding out that there is a hurricane season that starts on my birthday. For me, that was just like affirmations. But we're going to talk about what is going on. There's quite a bit to discuss in this video. So as you may have seen from the thumbnail, there is likely to be a rainfall increase in parts of the Caribbean. Some areas have been so dry, but you know, it seems as though some decent rain is on the way. And I'm not talking about rain to say, okay, it's just going to be one day and you guys get a lot of rain. No, it looks as though it could be consistent for a little while. So we're seeing that there is some activity in the eastern Pacific that is what is being watched for, some developments. So the National Hurricane Center has highlighted that area. And since the most recent update, the formation chance has not increased. So it remains at 30%. So let's see if something's going to consolidate over there, although most models are showing that eventually happening. And then there was that blob of showers, thunderstorms over parts of southern Mexico, northern Guatemala as well, but that's dissipating this morning. Seeing a bit of activity offshore the United States, much not happening for the Caribbean on a whole, and a bit of convection here and there in parts of the main development region. But overall, thanks to the dust that's been around that has helped to induce those drier and more stable conditions across parts of the main development region and the Caribbean as well. So we're going to be taking a look at the rainfall forecast for today, the wind forecast, the dust forecast, and then we're going to be talking about the potential rainfall increase in the region. First up, we've got the rainfall forecast here from Euro. So there could be some additional downpours in parts of Florida, the northern Bahamas. A few showers may loiter around parts of Cuba, the Cayman Islands, Jamaica, Hispaniola, Puerto Rico, the Virgin Islands, and through the Lesser Antilles. So there could be some showers, some intermittent showers around the area. And speaking of the Eastern Caribbean, there were two earthquakes. I'm going to talk about those as well. Going down to northern South America, Colombia, parts of Venezuela, Guyana, Suriname, French Guiana, it gets colorful down there as usual. There could definitely be some decent rainfall. For the ABC Islands, Aruba, Bonaire, Curacao, it is unlikely that you guys will receive much rain today. Maybe a passing shower if you're lucky. And then towards Central America, Panama, Costa Rica, parts of Nicaragua as well. It's been a bit active in that area. It should remain that way. Things get a bit drier for most of Honduras, Belize, parts of the Yucatan, and even Guatemala as well. Some spots in El Salvador. Moving on to the wind forecast, as we see more of these shades of blues and purples popping up, those winds are definitely getting stronger. So it is going to be a windy day across parts of the Bahamas and the Caribbean, especially the Southeast Caribbean and the Northwest Caribbean. So within the vicinity of the Yucatan, the Bay Islands of Honduras, Honduras, Belize, offshore Mexico, those winds will definitely be kicking up. But for parts of the northern Caribbean, winds may be anywhere from 5, maybe going up to 10 or 15 knots as we head throughout today. Going on to the dust forecast now, let's take a look at what is expected. So there is some residual dust from that most recent plume to make its way into the Caribbean, but another one is on the way. So as we're going to be heading into later this week, Friday, Saturday, going into next week, Sunday, that next plume should blanket the eastern Caribbean. So the Lesser Antilles, Puerto Rico, the Virgin Islands, ABC Islands, you guys are going to be blanketed. Also going to Hispaniola as well. But it is lessening. We can see that in the main development region, it is lessening. And once there's a break in that dust and more atmospheric instability, that's when we get those thunderstorms really going. And very soon, we're going to have that first tropical wave making its way off the African coast. Now, as it relates to these shakings around, so even though the atmosphere has been stable in some areas, the ground hasn't been so stable. There's been a couple of moderate shakings in the Caribbean, well, in and around the Caribbean. The stronger one was an estimated magnitude 5.6, and that happened last night offshore Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic. So the epicenter was offshore, but it is likely that the shaking was probably felt. You can let me know in the comments if you felt it in Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, maybe even the Virgin Islands as well. And then for the Eastern Caribbean Islands, there was an estimated magnitude 4.4 offshore St. Lucia and Martinique. So you can let me know if you felt that one as well. In addition, there have been some other minor quakes around, which is common for this area, especially the vicinity of Puerto Rico. It's common, but you know, from time to time, we do have these more significant shakings happening around. And it just serves as a reminder that we should always ensure that we are, you know, prepared, because these things, they happen without warning. It's just a matter of what you do in the moment that can determine a lot. Okay, so that is it in terms of the earthquakes. Again, an estimated magnitude 5.6. That was the strongest shaking in and around the Caribbean over the past day. Now let's move on to that potential rainfall increase. So we're looking at the Global Tropics Hazards Outlook map from the Climate Prediction Center. This was updated yesterday on the 14th, and we can see these spots of browns and these greens around. So that is indicating either above or below average rain. So the green indicates that there could be above average rain. The brown indicates that there could be below average rain. And the more the darker the colors are, the higher the chance. For example, for the week of May 22nd to the 28th, take a look at parts of Central America and the Western Caribbean. We're seeing here where it is expected that things might be a bit drier than normal. And we see the dark brown shading around parts of the Yucatan, Belize, Guatemala, Honduras, the Bay Islands as well. And that is indicating a much higher chance of, you know, those drier than normal conditions. Meanwhile, for the Eastern Caribbean, we're seeing that green shading popping up, going out to the main development region. So again, as I said, those tropical waves are going to start rolling off very, very soon. An increase in rainfall is expected for the Eastern Caribbean within this time frame. Again, May 22nd to May 28th. Go into the week of May 29th to June 4th. June 1st kickstarts the hurricane season. We see more of the Caribbean, most of the Caribbean actually, within this green shading, indicative of potential above average rainfall. And that would be super beneficial because what? It has been so dry in many areas. Many areas really need that spike in the rainfall chance. But I mean, unfortunately, with these rainfall events, sometimes when there's a quick heavy downpour, there can be flooding. So that's kind of the downside. But nonetheless, the rainfall is definitely needed. River velocities are low. And, you know, I'm sure that there are some restrictions in terms of water usage in some areas. But our models do show something interesting. Let's take a look at a couple of them. We've got the GFS model, and this is for next Wednesday on the 22nd of May. Look at this. We're seeing all these green shadings around indicating moisture, the precipitation rate. So GFS is showing that next week there could be an increase in moisture and rainfall in the whole for most of the Caribbean, the Greater Antilles, and even parts of the Lesser Antilles as well. And in the Pacific, that is the current area highlighted, the airflow pressure that may form. So by Wednesday of next week, GFS is expecting that, hey, this could be a hurricane loitering out there and moving off to the west in the Pacific. And the model shows this moisture, increase in moisture loitering around the Caribbean as we head to the following Sunday, the 26th of May. Pretty interesting. The ICON model, Wednesday of next week, again, we're seeing all these green shadings around, so there could be an increase in moisture, and Euro is also in agreement about this. And this is a good sign. When we start to see all these models expecting an increase in rain, it seems like it's, you know, definitely likely to come to fruition. But of course, we're still talking about the weather, and weather changes constantly. But I mean, eventually for the Caribbean, June through November, which is, you know, the hurricane season, is when we would typically expect to see the most rainfall happening in the region. So I know that areas such as Trinidad and Tobago have been really dry, and this rainfall increase, you know, if it should come true, it would be very much beneficial. But I'm here to keep you guys posted as per usual, and I just want to share with you what is expected as we're going to be heading into the next the weeks to come, really. So again, there were those moderate earthquakes in the Caribbean and other smaller ones. There is that disturbance, or that area highlighted rather, over the Eastern Pacific, where we could see developments happen over the course of the coming days. By the way, again, the first name on the list for the Pacific hurricane season is Aleta. So we may see Aleta within a couple of days. And there is also that potential increase in moisture and rainfall on a whole for sections of the Caribbean, but that next dust plume is on its way for this weekend and into next week. And so guys, that is it for right now. And I really hope that you found this video to be very informative. But if you have any questions, do feel free to leave them in the comments. I'll respond to you when I get the chance to do so. And remember to always be weatherwise.